Okay, so take a look at that face. It may look innocent, but it's actually the subject of tremendous controversy. It's called a nutria, or swamp rat, and here to tell us all about it is author Theo Manno. Theo, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks, Alex.
So, like I said, it looks innocent, but actually it has a pretty checkered history here in the United States. But I want to ask you, how did you start to research these things called nutria?
Well, when I was doing grad work at Auburn University, we had Hurricane Katrina hit. And during that time, I was reading that these big rats had eaten into the wetlands, and that might have exacerbated the effects of the hurricane. So I started reading about that and researching that. And over the years, I just got more information, and it built up into the book.
Wow. So, I mean, just to think that they could have contributed to that, it's kind of a crazy thing to think about. And the fact is, they're an invasive species. Could you sort of define what that means for us?
Sure. Well, it means a species that's not living here naturally. It's been introduced. And then on top of that, for some reason, it causes tremendous harm to human health or the environment. So because of the way they eat, the wetlands that buffer the Louisiana coast from the hurricane possibly might have been destroyed and made the effects from the hurricane worse.
Yeah, and so that's one of the effects, and I'm sure it's more far-reaching than we know. But what's the story behind them being introduced here in the United States?
Well, we used to have a very big fur industry, particularly in the Intermountain West, and then in the southern United States as well, and after we ran out of beaver and buffalo and other animals, fur farmers introduced nutria as sort of a niche fur. And it didn't work out too well. Originally, they produced and they reproduced very quickly. So they did get a lot of fur, but what happened was they were eventually released and they spread throughout the South. So we don't have much of a fur industry like it was now. But it did not work out too well.
I can see that, and I can see why they would also reproduce quickly. I mean, they're large rodents, and as we all know, if we've ever seen an infestation of those things, they produce pretty quickly. Now,
Right. Does
this have any history that relates back to Arizona in any way?
Well, we have not had any nutria introductions in Arizona, thankfully, even though we do have some wetland areas where it could happen. There were some in California. And the first person to introduce nutria, we think, introduced them to California and actually came into Arizona at one point and died here in Aguila. We're not sure why that was one of his residencies, but it's something that I look into in the book.
Well, certainly you're an authority on this. And in the book, from what I read about it, it's sort of like these true stories that read more like fiction. So what else can people expect from your book?
Well, there's a lot of stories in there about the old fur industry and what that was like. There are stories of the wild introductions that were very strange and bizarre, miscommunications between wildlife officials that led to the spreading of nutria throughout the South and the Pacific Northwest, and then some things that we can do to stunt the environmental problems that nutria have caused after their introduction.
Well, and in the last 30 seconds we have left, what do you think is the solution to this nutria problem?
Well, right now there's a bounty program, but in the book I talked to a chef who suggests that we start eating the nutria, and this gentleman was very interesting. We'd have to get over the problems that we have with eating a rat-like animal, but he wanted to start an industry where we have nutria steaks and things like that.
Oh,
we did it
gosh.
With alligator. We did it with things like crayfish. Might we be able to do it with the nutria? We'll see.
Maybe nutria jerky is in our future. I guess we'll see. But Theo,
maybe.
I want to thank you so much for joining us and telling us just a little snippet of what people can expect from your book.
Thank you very much.
Of course. Now, Swamp Rat, the story of Dixie's nutria invasion, is available now. You can purchase it at local bookstores or online at amazon.com/author/Theodore Manno.